Hello, I'm Yasmin from Kids Code Gen S, and I'm here to introduce AstroPi Mission Zero to Canadians. AstroPi is a European Space Agency project with the Raspberry Pi Foundation. Mission Zero is a non-competitive challenge where students aged 14 and under send a computer program to run on the Raspberry Pis that are currently on the International Space Station, otherwise known as the ISS. You'll be learning to code in a language called Python. Your program is going to do three things. It will show your message, display your image on screen, and then measure the temperature on board the space station. All students need is a computer and an internet connection. You don't need hardware or special coding skills. If you follow the rules, your program is guaranteed to run on the space station. They'll even send you a certificate with the time and date it ran. How cool is that? We want to ensure your student's program is successfully submitted to Mission Zero. To help support you, there's an official AstroPi Mission Zero self-paced tutorial or our KCJ information pack to use as a launching point. There are three steps to take before hosting a session. You'll find helpful links below this video. Step one, read through the Mission Zero online tutorial. Step two, look over the KCJ worksheets and sample program we provide. Step three, create an educator account. The registration code you receive allows students to submit their projects to Mission Zero and will allow the ISS to match your students' programs with the email address where they'll send certificates. There are five parts of an AstroPi session. First, start with a short introduction to AstroPi. What is it and what does it involve? Second, demonstrate a working program. You can use the coding template that KCJ provides. Third, form teams. Children can work in teams of 2 to 4 to submit one project. Fourth, work through the project. And finally, submit each project officially. And high five when it's done. We provide additional resources that make the project more accessible by separating the creative part from the coding part. Students can use the KCJ worksheet to create an image and a short message before they actually touch the keyboard. Now you're ready to code. Using Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge, open up Mission Zero on Trinket. It's important you use one of these browsers so that there are no compatibility issues once your program reaches outer space. In Trinket, you can type up the program that you will submit to run on board the ISS. The KCJ resources clarify the instructions on the Mission Zero webpage, which helps make sure that your code fits the format. These resources are supplemental, so we recommend you take a look at them. For most sessions, we'd recommend option one. Open a browser window on the Mission Zero emulator page and paste in the KCJ sample program. Modify the code to show the personalized message and image that you have created. For more advanced students, try option two. Follow the tutorial and code from scratch. It's a self-guided process, so you will need two browser windows open. In one, you'll have the Mission Zero emulator, and in the second window, you'll need the AstroPi tutorial to show you how to build your program step by step. This is important. Make sure your program is under 1,000 characters. The emulator will tell you if you're exceeding the limit, so you can adjust accordingly. Second, your code needs to be error-free. The emulator will tell you if there are any mistakes. You'll need to debug your code, which is always a part of programming. Look for your mistakes, correct them, and keep on going. The program can only run for under 30 seconds to give everyone a chance to get their program on the ISS. So the emulator has a timer built in to the bottom corner to make sure you're within the limits. Teams should run their programs repeatedly as they write it. Try something, test it. Try something new, test it. Keep on testing. The AstroPi emulator will help you check that your program works the way you want it to. Now the program is ready and it's passed all the checks. Remember, once it's officially submitted, no more changes can be made. So to submit the project, enter your educator registration code. Follow the instructions on screen. The names entered on the form will appear on the official certificate. And in June, after the projects have run, the official certificates will be sent to the email associated with the educator account. Remember, the astronauts up in the space station will see your projects, so brighten up their day. Participate and send your code to the stars.